Last unit is theoretical distributions. So in few units we have few topics left that after completion of this unit we'll do that one. In theoretical distributions you have three types of distribution, means types of problems we can say. We have binomial, Poisson and normal. So we have three types of questions, three topics in this unit. In first topic, what you need to remember is those three, four formulas are there. Based on these formulas, you can easily do problems. Same like probability itself. If I ask you mean, you have to tell n into p, where n represents number of times, experiment repetitions, whatever given. If experiment is repeated 5 times, so n is equals to 5. If the experiment is repeated, experiment means suppose if I'll toss a coin 100 times, n is equals to 100 that time. That means I am repeating the experiment number of times. So whenever number of times are more, that time we'll use binomial distribution. Why we'll not use direct probability? See, if a coin is tossed, then we have some distribution. If a bag contains 3 balls, 4 balls, 5 balls, we can do by using probability formulas. But if 400 balls are taken out 2 times, in that way if the question is given, experiment is repeated number of times and binomial word is mentioned in the question, maximum they'll use binomial. If they'll not use binomial distribution, you can solve by using any of the three methods. So maximum questions, wherever binomial is there, they'll give you binomial distribution word in the question. Mean is n into p, variance is n into p into q, where p and q are probability. Suppose p is probability of success, happening we can say. Always happening is taken as p. What is meaning by happening? Suppose if I ask you, taking out a red ball, probability is 4. If out of 2 balls, probability of red ball is 4. Probability of red ball is 4 out of 7 balls. So 4 out of 7. Probability of not getting red ball, that is non-happening. Happening is 4. So non-happening is 3 by 7. In that one, we have P of A and P of A bar. P of A means whatever probability. A bar means opposite to that probability. Suppose one person is going and going for interview and the chances of getting selected is 1 out of 3. 1 out of 3 are selecting. That means happening chances are 1 out of 3. Non-happening, not getting the job, is 2 by 3. That means this is P and this is Q. So in probability, happening thing is taken as P. Non-happening thing is taken as Q. At the time of problem, you are going to get this. P is probability of happening, Q is probability of non-happening, N is number of times experiment is repeated, standard deviation, whatever variance answer you'll get, just take a root of that one, that is standard deviation. Now this is P of capital X is equals to small x, NCX into P power X into Q power N minus X. This is the formula which we'll use to find the probability of any event. Suppose probability of x is equals to 1, that time we will take n c x value 1, p of 1, q power n minus 1. N means number of times. So easily what you have to do is you have to by heart these formulas first. P of x is equals to small x in binomial distribution. In Poisson also p of x is equals to small x is there, e power minus m into m power x by x factorial. That is different formula. Now we are doing binomial, so just bother about this binomial distribution thing. In binomial distribution what we have? P of x is equals to ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. For expected frequency, same formula with capital N. Means whenever one table is given to you in which a number of frequency, sum of frequency is given, that time we will take capital N. So why, how to do the problems and all, you will get to know now. This chapter contains total 3 exercises. Exercise 1. First problem from exercise 1. Eight coins are thrown. Show that probability of getting at least 6 heads is 37 by 256. how to think that this question does not belong to probability? See, number of times they'll give. Eight coins are thrown. So total number of coins were 8. We need to get at least 6 sets. So how many coins were there? Number of coins, 8. Whenever coins are there, then probability of getting head is 1/2. Probability of not getting head is 1/2. So these are the three things we have to find. What is the question they have given? Probability of at least 6 head. Probability of at least 6 heads. That equals to probability of x is greater than equal to 6. So the greater than equal to 6, we have formulas for this one. Either 6 or 7 or 8. Leave this question for a while. Now I'll explain you what is this. Probability of, if I'll ask you, x is greater than 7. Greater than 6. X is greater than equal to 6. These two are not same. This is only greater than, this has greater than equal to. Whenever x is greater than 6 means, how many coins are there? 8 coins are there. Greater than 6 means 7. X is equal to 7 or x is equals to 8 or means plus sign. Whereas greater than equal to 6, either 6 or 7 or 8. So in this way you need to write. Now if I'll ask you, p of x is less than 2. Less than 2 means either it is 1, 0 or 1. We will not take 2 because less than 2 is there. If less than equal to, less than means L type symbol you have, L type. Less than equal to mean p of x is equals to 2 also you have to consider. Or for x is greater than equal to, at least 6 means, if I'll ask you, if we have 8 balls in our bag, I'll ask you to get at least 6 balls. What you'll do? You can get 6 balls or you can get 7 balls or you can get 8 balls. At least 6 means I have given the limit to you that you have to get at least that. So in that way, so p of x is equals to 6 is given. Now you have to write down the formula here in the box. Probability formula, p of x is equals to small x ncx p power x into q power n minus x. N is 8. 8c, x is 6 into p. P is 1/2 in bracket. Power x. X is how much? 6 into q. Q is 1/2. N minus x. 8 minus 6. Or 8c 7. 1/2 power 7. 1/2 power 8 minus 7. Similarly, plus 8c 8. 1/2 power 8, 1/2 power 8 minus 8. 8c6 is how much? 8, 6 times reverse, or else you can take the difference. 8 minus 6 is 2. 8 into 7 by 1 into 2. 8 minus 6 difference is 2, so you can take 2 times reverse. 1/2, 6 times into 1/2, 2 times. Or 8c7, 8 by 1. 1/2 power 7 into 1/2 power 1. 8c8, 1. 8 reversed 8 times, forward 8 times. 1/2 power 8, anything per 0 is 1. So this is 2, 4 times 8, 4 sevens. 28 into 1/2 power 8. Plus 8/2 power 8. Plus 1/2 power 8. 2 power 8 LCM. 2 power 8 is how much? 64. 2 into 2 into 2, 8 times. This is 28 plus 8 plus 1. 37 divided by 2 power 8 is not 64. 4, 16, 256. So this is 256. So by seeing one problem, you will not get this. For coin problem, what you have to remember? 8 coins, number of coins were 8. Then coins probability always 1/2 and 1/2. This formula, at least 6 head means what you have to do? You have to remember this formula for at least 6 heads. If you will see 2-3 problems, then you get, you will definitely get idea of doing this one. Now in this question they have given the probability of happening of an event is 0.4. Probability of happening 0.4 means 4/10. I have taken p equals what I said you earlier in the formula list. P is happening probability. Q is non-happening of this one. 4 out of 10 cases it happens, or 6 out of 10 cases it will not happen. Then find the probability of happening at least once of the experiment is repeated 3 times. Times is given, n is equals to 3. So by the given question, you have to able to get these three values. Once you get these three values, they may give you binomial probability. They will mention binomial distribution, or else if they will not mention also, if happening is given, you will write non-happening, and number of times means you have to think that this question belongs to binomial distribution. So for binomial distribution, if we have three things, what they want us to find, find the probability of happening event at least once. Probability of at least once. At least once means at least one time. One time means either 1 or greater than equal to 1. This equals to xp of x is equals to 1. Number of x, 3 means we have to go till 3 in this way. Or else what you can do, you can write in this way also. At least once, what you did in probability, 1 minus none. Probability of 1 minus x is equals to 0. This one you can do. Or else this one. So this concept we have will do in this way. First we'll write formula of probability. So I'll write here p of x is equals to x equals to ncx into p power x into q power n minus x. Now p is x is equals to 1. See, wherever x is there, 1 we'll write here, 3 cases, n is 3, we'll write n plus 3 and p plus 4/10, q plus 6/10. NCX, so 3C1 into P power X, 4/10 power 1 into Q power N minus X, 6/10 power 3 minus 1 plus 3C, just N plus you can change, 4/10 power 2, 6/10 power 3 minus 2, then plus 3C3, 4/10 power 3 into 6/10 power 3 minus 3. 3C1, 3/1. This is 4/10. This is 6/10, 2 times, because 3 minus 1 is 2. 3C2, 3 into 2 by 1 into 2. 4/10, 2 times. Into 6/10, 1 time. Plus 3C3 is 1. Into 4/10, 3 times. Now 3 minus 3 is 0. Anything for 0 is 1, not 0. Now we'll multiply, cancelling this one. Don't cancel tens, always leave as it is. This is 1000, 3 4s are 12, 12 into 6 into 6, 36, 432. Then 3 4s are 12 into 24, 288. 4 4s are 16, 16 4 times 64. So we have 1000 LCM, 432, 288 and 64 is 784. You can leave it up to here, or else 0.784 is probability of at least once x is greater than equal to 1. At least 6 we have done in the previous one. P of x is greater than equal to 6 is that value. What is given to us in this one? The overall percentage of failures in the examination. Failure is mentioned to us. Overall failures were 40. So whenever failures are given, we'll not take P as 40 by 100. Percentage means 40 by 100. We'll take how many of them are pass out of 100? 60 out of 100, P, Q is 40, failure is not taken as P, P should be taken as pass candidates, N is equals to, how many candidates are there, at least 4 pass the examination, probability that out of 6 candidates, number of candidates were 6, at least 4 is our probability, that at least number of terms are, at least is given, at least 4, P of X is greater than equal to 4. So out of 6, 4 means either 4 or 5 or 6. Check this one from question, how we got P and Q values. Overall percentage of failures in the examination, they have given 40. Percentage means out of 100, 40. 40 are failures. So how many are passouts from this one? 60, those who have passed the exam. Failures are 40, those who have passed were 60. So P is always taken as positive thing. Pass values. Now formula, P of x is equals to x, ncx into p power x into q power n minus x. 4, n is 6, 6 is c, 4, p is 110, we can cancel. Okay, p is 6 by 10 power x, x is here, into 4 by 10 power n minus x, n minus x, so n minus x is 6 minus 4 plus 5, means just change this 5, wherever 4 is there just write 5. Or else six C four, subtract them. You can take like this: 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 by 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, or just two terms. How to get these two? 6 minus 4 is 2. You can take the difference of these two. Once the difference is 2, then reverse 2 times, forward 2 times. Or 6 by 10. How many times we have? 4 times. 4 by 10, 2 times. Or 6 by 1, 6 by 10, 5 times. 4 by 10 1 times. 6 is 6 is 1. 6 by 10 is 6 times. This is cancelled. After multiplying this line by using calculator, you will get 311040 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. Then if you multiply 36 into 36 into 36 into 4, 18624 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then 6 times, 46656 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have single value 6 zeros, then these all the values added, we'll get 5, 4, 4, 3, 2, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0 cancel, divided 0.54432 is the answer. The incidence of disease is such that an average of 20% workers suffer from it. Probability of happening the disease is 20%. Q is non-happening of the disease is 80%. Then n is equals to number of workers selected. 10 workers are selected. Find the probability. First bit, probability of exactly 2 workers. Exactly 2 is given, so P of x is equals to 2. So the formula is P of x is equals to small x ncx p power x into q power n minus x. So ncx, n is 10, cx is 2, p power, p is 20 by 100, so this is 2 by 10, 2 by 10 power x, x is 2, q power 8 by 10 power n minus x, 10 minus 2, so this is 10 into 9 by 1 into 2, 2 by 10 2 times, 8 by 10, 8 by 10 is 8 times. So what we'll do, 8 by 10 power 8, this is 45 into 4 by 100 into 8 power 8 by 10 power 8, you can leave it up to this mark. Or if you want to multiply that, you can multiply, you will get 0.302. You have calculator, you can multiply and check the result of this one. Then second bit is, not more than 2 suffer from it. Not more than 2. If I'll ask you, to get, see, you can get not more than 2 apples for me. What you'll do? Not more than 2 means what? Up to 2 only. So either you will not get anything, or you can get 1 apple for me, or you can get 2 apples for me. If I'll ask you to get not more than 2 of anything, suppose get chalk pieces not more than 2. So either you can get nothing, or you can get 1 chalk piece for me, or you can get 2 chalk pieces for me. So same formula, P of x is equals to x. So ncx, 10c 0, p power x, 2 by 10 power x, q power n minus x, 8 by 10 power 10 minus 0, or 10c 1, 2 by 10 power 1, 8 by 10 power 10 minus 1, or 10c 2, 2 by 10 power 2, 8 by 10 power 10 minus 2. Similarly, simplification, any c 0 is 1, anything power 0 is also 1, 8 power 10, 10 power 10. Or else 10c 1 is 10 by 1, 2 power 1 by 10 power 1, 8 power 9 by 10 power 9. 10c 2, 10 into 9 by 1 into 2, and 2 power 2 by 10 power 2, 8 power 8 by 10 power 8. So 10 power 10 is common in denominator. This is 8 power 10 by 10 power 10. 20 into 8 power 9 by 10 power 10. 45 into 4 into 8 power 8. 8, 8 times multiply, then 10 power 10. So 10 power 10 is in denominator. How much is 8 power 10? Multiply and write it. We have the values here. You can try by your side first. 30198988880 or 208435456 0 or 107374184. If you'll divide and everything, you will get 0.6776. The occupational hazard in an industry is such that, see, what is the meaning of hazard? Suppose one, if you are working in cement factory, the lung cancer, getting lung cancer is a hazard in that one. So similarly, if you work in any of the coal mines, getting skin infection is a hazard in that one. So in that way, occupational hazard is an industry such that the worker have 20% chance of facing it. 20% chance of facing it, probability P is equals to 20% chance is there we can face, and Q is not facing, that is 80 by 100. See, P we can take 80 by 100, but the thing is, whatever we'll find, more we'll face. Facing is P always. What depends on question, what they'll ask. N is equals to that out of 6 workers, N is equal to 4 or more will face the hazard. P of 4 or more. 4 or more means either 4 or 5, N is 6, so or 6. If N is 8, we can take 7, 8 also. So the formula is same, P of x is equals to small x, ncx, p power x, q power n minus x. X is equals to 4. So ncx, n is 6, c, x is 4. P is 2 by 10, this is 8 by 10. P power x into q power 8 by 10 power n minus x, 6 minus 4. Or 6c5, 2 by 10 power 6 2 by power 5. 8 by 10 power 6 minus 5. 6 is 6, 2 by 10 power 6, and 8 by 10 power 6 minus 6. 6 minus 4 is 2. 6 into 5 by 1 into 2. Or if you are interested, you can write 6 into 5 into 4 into 2 in that way. 2 by 10 into 2 by 10 into 2 by 10 into 2 by 10. 8 by 10 2 times. 8 by 10 into 8 by 10. 6 by 5, 6 into 1, 2 by 10, 5 times. 8 by 10, 1 times. 66 is 1, 2 power 6, 10 power 6, 8 power 0 is 1. 3 2s are 6, 2s are 12, 2s are 24, 2 times 48. In that way, if you will divide it by multiplying and dividing, if you add 0.0172, approximately you will get it.